Mitzi Jones, Howard Greenback, Anna Greenback, John Greenback, Marie Miller, Leroy Miller, Robert Baker Sr., Gene Baker, Robert Kletcher, Thomas Bias, Guy H. Bias, Wilmer B. Bias, Sean Nicholson, Ellen Sane, Robert Brown, Esther Brown, H.B. Brown, Doris Peace, Irving Peace, Thomas E. Hudson Jr., Emery and Madeline Hudson, John Hastings, Betty Maluska, John Bentley Hart, Charlotte Irene Hart, John Edward Hart, Donald A. Green, George and Helen Eder, Howard and Carolyn Swinson, Robert and Doris Schmidt, Wesley and Faye Pazowski, Anna Devon Graham, Nancy Miller Fromm, Robert E. Stalt, Holly Ruth Stalt, Deacon Bob Runkle, Catherine Thierre, Elizabeth Butcher, Thomas Thierre, George Thierre, Matthew Thierre, Kenneth Thierre, Gary Wolf, William Hall, Richard Hall, Mr. and Mrs. James M. Price, Patricia G. Price, Susan Knott.
We beseech you that rejoicing in their fellowship, encouraged by their example and aided by their prayers, we also may finish our course in faith, and that at the day of resurrection, we, with all those who are of the mystical body of your Son, may be set on his right hand and hear his most joyful voice. Come, you blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Grant this, O lover of souls, for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our only mediator and advocate. Amen.
Thank you.
Blessed be God, most holy, glorious, and undivided Trinity. Amen. Let us pray together. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. God be with you. Let us pray. O God, whose blessed Son came into the world that he might destroy the works of the devil and make us children of God and heirs of eternal life, grant that having this hope, we may purify ourselves as he is pure, that when he comes again with power and great glory, we may be made like him in his eternal and glorious kingdom, where he lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Please be seated for the lessons.
A reading from the book of Job. Job said, "Oh, that my words were written down. Oh, that they were inscribed in a book. Oh, that with an iron pen and with lead, they were engraved on a rock forever. For I know that my Redeemer lives, and that at the last he will stand upon the earth. And after my skin has been thus destroyed, then in my flesh I shall see God, whom I shall see on my side, and my eyes shall behold and not another." Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Read Psalm 17 responsively by whole verse. Hear my plea, O innocents, O God. Give heed to my cry. Listen to my prayer, which does not come from lying lips. Weigh my heart. Summon me by night, melt me down. You will find no impurity in me. My footsteps hold fast to the ways of your law. In your paths, my feet shall not stumble. Show me your marvelous loving kindness, O Savior of those who take refuge at your right hand, from those who rise up against them. From the wicked who will assault me, from my deadly enemies who surround me. A reading from the second letter to the Thessalonians. As to the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and our being gathered together to him, we beg you, brothers and sisters, not to be quickly shaken in mind or alarmed, either by spirit or by word or by letter, as though from us the effect that the day of the Lord is already here. Let no one deceive you in any way, for that day will not come unless the rebellion comes first and the lawless one is revealed, one destined for destruction. He opposes and exalts himself above every so-called God or object of worship, so that he takes his seat in the temple of God, declaring himself to be God. Do you not remember that I told you these things when I was still with you? But we must always give thanks to God for you, brothers and sisters, beloved by the Lord, because God chose you as the first fruits for salvation through sanctification by the Spirit, and through belief in the truth. For this purpose, he called you through our proclamation of the good news, so that you may obtain the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. So then, brothers and sisters, stand firm and hold fast to the traditions that you were taught by us, either by word of mouth or by letter. Now may our Lord Jesus Christ himself and God our Father, who loved us and through grace gave us eternal comfort and good hope, comfort your hearts and strengthen them in every good work and word. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Gospel this morning is different from what's written in your bulletin, so please just sit back and enjoy the gospel. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus looked at his disciples and said, "Blessed are you who are poor, for yours is the kingdom of God. Blessed are you who are hungry now, for you will be filled. Blessed are you who weep now, for you will laugh. Blessed are you when people hate you, and when they exclude you, revile you, and defame you on account of the Son of Man. Rejoice in that day and leap for joy, for surely your reward is great in heaven. For that is what their ancestors did to the prophets. But woe to you who are rich, for you have received your consolation. Woe to you who are full now, for you will be hungry. Woe to you who are laughing now, for you will mourn and weep. Woe to you who speak well of you, for that is what their ancestors did to the false prophets. But I say to you that listen, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, bless those who curse you. Pray for those who abuse you. If anyone strikes you on the cheek, offer the other also. And from anyone who takes away your coat, do not withhold even your shirt. Give to everyone who begs from you. And if anyone takes away your goods, do not ask for them again. Do to others as you would have them do to you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Be seated. My brothers, sisters, gender resistors, sinners and saints, one and all, welcome on this beautiful All Saints Day. It's so good to be here with you. So we've had a bit of a glitch in the lectionary this morning, and our readings are for a non All Saints Sunday, but today is most assuredly All Saints Sunday. There's something special about All Saints Sunday since the ratification of the prayer book that we currently have. So you may notice in the pocket in front of you a red book that says the Book of Common Prayer. We hardly ever use it anymore, but what you see in front of you is actually a tremendously radical document. Doesn't look radical. It looks quite staid, but it is in fact quite radical because in that book, the Episcopal Church gave a whole refreshed understanding of what we do at baptism, how we do it, and what we're doing, a different understanding from what people were doing in the Episcopal Church and indeed in the Anglican tradition for a long time. In the earliest days of baptism, and I promise not to make this too heavy, but in the earliest days of baptism, we have an early record from about 65 to 80 AD, something like that, instructions on how to do baptism. There's no explanation about why we do baptism. There's no explanation about the theology of baptism or what it's for or what it means. All it says is this, that you should do baptism in living water, which is to say water that's moving, so preferably like a river. And if you can't do it in living water, then do it in still water. And it should be cold. But if it's not cold, it's okay if it's warm. And if you can't find any water in which to baptize somebody outside, then it's okay to pour water over their head, but it should be cold. I think that's very interesting, the emphasis on cold water. I wonder what that meant about baptism for people, that it should be shocking, right? That there should be something about the experience of baptism that it should wake you up, that it should be clearly a life-changing experience. And then over the years, as people are wont to do, because things are never enough when we want to make them special, layers and layers and layers of other things were added on to what we do for baptism until by the Middle Ages, you couldn't be baptized, the baby would not be baptized until after an exorcism was performed. And then the baptism could be performed. But always, always, always by the Middle Ages, the expectation was infant baptism. So of course, in the earliest days of the church, the expectation was adult baptism, not infant baptism, not necessarily even child's baptism, although we don't know that for sure. But by the time we get to the Middle Ages, there's an expectation that children, that babies will be born as soon, will be baptized just as soon as possible. Because there had grown to be a belief that if a baby died before he or she was baptized, that baby was going to go at best into a place called purgatory, which was not a very, very nice place. It was probably the worst daycare you could imagine for an infant. And there they would stay until it was hard to know how long. And that idea about baptism being a kind of magic spell grew. Now, it didn't begin that way, but there did emerge over time a sense that the sinfulness of even an infant baby was so strong that it had to be washed away by a ritual bath lest the baby be condemned to hell. And baptism was the magic ritual that would prevent that from happening. It was it chased away the danger. It was something that the church did, and in particular, It was what the hierarchy of the church did, bishops or priests. That's what bishops and priests did in order to save babies from the fires of hell. Well, this kind of idea about babies and baptism persisted for a long, long time, hundreds, even thousands of years. What is radical, completely radical, about the 1979 prayer book, which you see in front of you, is that we thought together, prayed together, tested together, talked to our friends and neighbors in other denominations, and we decided that Jesus did that already. Jesus saved us already from the fires of hell. So what is baptism for then? Baptism is the outward sign of the inward truth that we are grafted onto the body of Christ, that we become one among the communion of saints. We become a mystical union that is the body of Christ. And in our baptism, as adults, or as children, promises made for us by our parents and godparents, we commit to living a life that is in concert with the teachings of Jesus Christ. That we commit to living a life that is worthy of what has already been done for us by Jesus Christ. We are already saved from the fires of hell. And we do not, in fact, require priests and bishops to make that salvation real. So our baptism is now never private. Up until 1979, the expectation was that baptisms would be private. My baptisms were private. Notice I say baptisms. I had two of them. I had two of them as a baby because I had half a family on one coast and half a family on the other. Clearly, my baptisms had very little to do with Jesus. They had much more to do with welcoming me into families, which was beautiful. But that happened before 1979. I bet many of us here were baptized in private ceremonies. But if you were baptized after 1979, it was done in a public ceremony because the whole point is that we're joining the communion of saints. The whole point is that the person being baptized is becoming one among us. Also important about this service is that it cannot be done in private just by a priest because the community must be present. You'll notice in our ritual, it is essential that the community make commitments as well to the baptized person and reaffirm our own baptismal promises. The last thing that I want to talk about that changed with the 1979 prayer book is that baptisms were not exactly restricted, but we are encouraged to do them four times during the year. We're encouraged to do them on this day, the Sunday of All Saints. We're encouraged to do them on the Feast of the Baptism of Our Lord. We're encouraged to do them at the Great Vigil of Easter and at Pentecost. And there are two reasons for that. One reason is that these particular holidays remind us in the readings and in the prayers, they remind us of our unity as the body of Christ. They remind us what is happening with baptism, and our readings and our prayers emphasize this for us, that our baptismal candidates joining the great communion of saints who have been, who are now, and who will be. But the other reason that we do that is to build in our baptismal covenant into our liturgical year. And so four times a year, whether we're baptizing someone or not, we reaffirm our baptismal covenant. We say together, instead of the regular creed that we normally say, we say the baptismal covenant, committing ourselves, recommitting ourselves 4 times a year to following Jesus Christ, accepting him as our Savior, to rejecting those aspects of the world that are harmful and damaging and cruel, and affirming our desire to follow in the way of the traditions of our church and of our Lord Jesus Christ. So that's what makes that radical. So what I want to say now is that this water is cold. Be aware that this water is cold. Be grateful that unlike the Didache, we will not require that you strip down naked and soak in it. But there will be a lot of water and it will be very cold, because today your lives change. You've already been members of this church. You've already come to the altar. You've already received Holy Eucharist. You've already experienced the presence of Christ. But today you make a commitment. Today you make a commitment, understanding that your life has changed, understanding that because Jesus has done what he has done for us, you are now free to walk in a way that is different, to walk with a community that loves you and will support you, and that asks us all to live differently from the world, which does not always have our best interests at heart. Today, we welcome Leo and we welcome Brittany into the body of Christ. And though not everyone here has made the same choice to be a part of the body of Christ, at this time, we proclaim, we assert, we are sure and confident that the Spirit of God will be present for all of us in whatever way feels most natural and most real for us. And our lives, too, will be changed. Amen. We will not say the Nicene Creed today, but instead we will begin processing to the font, singing Take Me to the Water on page 7 of your bulletin. Please stand for our hymn. So please be seated.
Take me to the water.
you all need a leaflet? Okay. All right, let's try that once more with enthusiasm. Will you be responsible for seeing that this child you present is brought up in both the Christian faith and life, as well as Jewish teaching and tradition? Will you, by your prayers and witness, help this child grow into the full stature of Christ? All right, now these questions are addressed to you, Brittany, and to the parents and godparents of Leo. Do you renounce Satan and all the spiritual forces of wickedness that rebel against God? Do you renounce the evil powers of this world which corrupt and destroy the creatures of God? Do you renounce all sinful desires that draw you from the love of God? Do you turn to Jesus Christ and accept him as your Savior? Do you put your whole trust in his grace and love? Do you promise to follow and obey him as your Lord? And will you who witness these vows do all in your power to support these persons in their life in Christ? Let us join with those who are committing themselves to Christ and renew our own baptismal covenant. Do you believe in God the Father? Please stand. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God? Ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God. Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit? In the apostles' teachings, in the fellowship, and in the breaking of the bread and the prayers? Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord? Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ? Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself? Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being? Let us now pray for these persons who are to receive the sacrament of new birth.
Deliver them, O Lord, from the way of sin and death.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Open their hearts to your grace and truth.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Fill them with your holy and life-giving spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Keep them in the faith and communion of your holy church.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Teach them to love others in the power of the Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Send them into the world in witness to your love.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring them to the fullness of your peace and glory.
Lord, hear our prayer. Grant, O Lord, that all who are baptized into the death of Jesus Christ, your Son, may live in the power of his resurrection, and look for him to come again in glory, who lives and reigns now and forever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give
Now I'm going to ask all children to please come forward and help me to bless this water. Want to help me out, Gabe? All right. Any other little ones who want to come and give me a hand? Okay. Yeah. You can slip through the fence. Just slip through the fence. Come through the fence. It's all good. Yep. Free the font. That's what I say. Free the font. All right. Now put your hands in there. Put your hands in. Okay. We thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water. Over it, the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through it, you led the children of Israel out of their bondage in Egypt and through the land of promise. In it, your son, Jesus, received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us through his death and resurrection from the bondage of sin into everlasting life. We thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. In it, we are buried with Christ in his death. By it, we share in his resurrection. Through it, we are born by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son, we bring into his fellowship those who come to him in faith, yes, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. All right, now I need everybody's pause in here, okay? Everybody's pause. Okay, that's all right. Oh, everybody okay? Okay. Now, sanctify this water, we pray you, by the power of your Holy Spirit, that those who are here cleansed from sin and born again may continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ our Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever.
Amen.
Now off you go. All right, Brittany. I'm going to mess up your hair. Okay? You good? Head over. Yeah, that'll be good. All right. Where would you like me to pour it so I do the least damage? Like right there? Okay. Brittany, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. There you go. These are all wet, but you'll manage. All right, let me at him. You ready? It's chilly. It's chilly, but it's gonna be great. It's gonna be great. Ooh, whoops. That's all right. I can do it by hand. We got it? Okay. All right, we're on it. All right, sweetie. You ready? Leo, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. All right, don't take him too far. That's right. That's exactly right. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that by water and the Holy Spirit, you have bestowed upon these, your servants, the forgiveness of sin, have raised them to the new life of grace. Sustain them, O Lord, in your Holy Spirit. Give them an inquiring and discerning heart and the courage to will and to persevere, a spirit to know and to love you, and the gift of joy and wonder in all your works. Amen. All right. I'm going to need you back. I'll do Leo first. What I'm doing now is I'm anointing him with oil, which is a sign of the Holy Spirit coming upon him and initiating him fully into the body of Christ. All right? Here we go. Oh, Leo, I anoint you by the power of the Holy Spirit and mark you as Christ's own forever. Amen. I know it smells like patchouli, but you'll be all right. Brittany, you are sealed by the power of the Holy Spirit and marked as Christ's own forever. Amen. We also have for each of you a sign of the light of Christ. I know everyone's getting very antsy, but we're going to have crackers and juice in just a minute. These candles are a symbol of the light of Christ into which you've been baptized. I encourage you to consider on the anniversary of your baptism to light these candles to remember the commitments that you have made. Brittany? And that's for Leo. And just because we can't have too many gifts. Brittany, this is a combination of a Holy Bible and the Book of Common Prayer. I encourage you to hold it fast, but not to just use it as a paperweight. It is full of love letters to you from Jesus. All right. This is much smaller, but it is also full of love letters, a children's Bible for Leo, and I hope that it will help him to grow in faith. Thank you, Henry. And now, let us welcome the newly baptized. Something to say. We receive you into the household of God, confess the faith of Christ crucified, proclaim his resurrection, and share with us in his eternal priesthood. And now, at the peace, I encourage you to introduce yourselves to our newest members of the body of Christ, Leo and Brittany, who will parade themselves or be paraded around the church. Because the peace of the Lord be always with you. Please greet one another in a sign of peace. Peace be with you. All right, so as Brittany and Leo are going around, I want to remind you that there are other people we are celebrating today as well, and you don't have to keep that lit for the whole thing. Okay. Yeah, you don't want to get wax on your pretty dress. Okay. Do we have anniversaries, birthdays, or travelers today? What are we celebrating today? Birthdays. When's your birthday? On election day. I hope you get a good present. Is it your birthday also?
It is also on election day.
That's fantastic. Birthdays, travelers? Oh. Okay, when is your anniversary?
I guess it's election day.
Tuesday. My goodness, that was a very big day. And how many years? 19. Well done, you. And how about you, Pat? You're traveling. Of course you're traveling. All right. All right, we'll start with birthdays. Hugh and Haley, and our birthday blessing is toward the top of page 12. We say together, "Oh God, our times are in your hand. Look with favor, we pray, on your servants as they begin another year. Grant that they may grow in wisdom and grace and strengthen their trust in your goodness all the days of their life. through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. All right, and we are praying for the Pollux, 19 years. It's fantastic. O God, who has given us the sacrament of marriage, that we may know you through the intimacy of married love, send therefore your blessing upon these your servants, that they may so love, honor, and cherish each other in faithfulness and patience, in wisdom and kindness, that their home may be a haven of blessing and peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Congratulations. So where are you headed? Just Virginia. Okay. Oh, I see. We will hold you in prayer. We pray together for Pat. O God, our Heavenly Father, whose glory fills the whole creation and whose presence we find wherever we go, preserve those who travel, especially these your children. Surround her with your loving care. Protect her from every danger and bring her in safety to her journey's end. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Happy birthday, happy anniversary, safe travels, one and all. There's a lot going on. Tomorrow night, we are having an election eve prayer service outside, if weather permits. It'll be candlelight service of evening prayer. We are praying not for particular candidates. The only outcome we are praying for is justice, peace, and good governance. That is what we hope is for wisdom to prevail in our elections. And so all are welcome, regardless of your political orientation or opinions. This is so important. As the unified body of Christ, it is essential that we should be able to pray together for the well-being of our country, regardless of what we think that looks like individually. We should be able to pray for goodness and justice and peace together. So please join us tomorrow evening at 7 p.m. We got a lot of other stuff going on, and there are some other people who want to make announcements. So I'll just call your attention on page 2 of the announcements to the Thanksgiving Basket collection program. That's coming up, and so please keep an eye on that. If you're not able to donate bags of groceries, checks are welcome to ACTC, but please do participate in that. And if you do bring a bag, please make sure to put your name and Trinity's name on it so that we can account for how many bags we have given. All right, Joanne Lindsay wanted to make some announcements. And no one will hear you from there, so please.
That's okay, I'll talk about that. I just want to say that the holidays are quickly approaching, and very soon you'll see a really lovely display of pumpkins and a cornucopia, squashes up on the altar for Thanksgiving, and then later poinsettias for Christmas. The altar guild works very hard to every week, but particularly in the holidays.
Thank you. Oh, one more thing. Okay.
That's totally good. As we all know, the elections are coming up in 2 days. And for the first time,
Thank you. Thank you, Joanne. Thank you. And thank you for safeguarding our democracy. Also, our organist, Hardwick Spencer, is an election judge, isn't that? You do more than that. And a trainer of election judges. He's been safeguarding our elections for a long, long time. So I say thank you, Hardwick. Thank you, Joanne. And thanks to all of you who participate in our civic process to keep. Oh, Mary Beth, yes, will also be serving as a judge. All right, now I ask you to offer to God a sacrifice of thanksgiving and make good your vows to the Most High. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, because in Jesus Christ our Lord, you have received us as your sons and daughters, made us citizens of your kingdom, and given us the Holy Spirit to guide us into all truth. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Amen.
Gracious Father, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you, in your mercy, sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for all for the forgiveness. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit, that they may be for us the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Hallelujah! Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. The people of God. This is the table not of the church, but of the Lord. It is made ready for those who love God and for those who want to love God more. So come, you who have much faith and you who have little, you who have been here often and you who have not been here long, you who have tried to follow and you who have fallen short, come. It is the Lord who invites you. It is Jesus' will that those who wish to meet him should find him here. Amen. I invite first our newly baptized forward for Holy Communion. We will have to your left, we will have the common cup and an intinction cup. To your right, only an intinction cup. There will be two sources for bread and three sources for wine. So you may drink from the common cup on this side, or you may intinct from either side. But all are welcome at Christ's table. Brittany, would you come forward? Body of Christ, the bread of heaven. All may come forward to receive the sacrament. Thank you. Let us pray. God of abundance, you have fed us with the bread of life and cup of salvation. You have united us with Christ and one another, and you have made us one with all your people in heaven and on earth. Now send us forth in the power of your Spirit, that we may proclaim your redeeming love to the world and continue forever in the risen life of Christ our Savior. Amen. May God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side, and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.
Rejoicing in the power of the Spirit.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.